So I'm really a songwriter for the most part. That's my focus for many years, really since I was a teenager. But like everybody else, I started out playing tons of covers. When I was about 14 or 15, my brother and I probably had 150 songs, and we got our first gigs playing in some little restaurants and things in New Jersey growing up. And in the last about 7 or 8 years, I've just come around again to really getting interested in revisiting songs that I knew, in some cases from way back, or songs that I fell in love with later by other people, and arranging them for to play like this, solo on one guitar. And in a lot of cases, finding new ways to play these tunes that kind of reflect all of what I've learned about guitar from all these years of playing and writing songs. I was the founding editor of Acoustic Guitar Magazine, and have worked for decades on acoustic guitar. And I find arranging songs is just a great change-up for a songwriter. It kind of uses a different part of the brain. It's almost like a puzzle sometimes to me to listen to a great song and figure out some way, interesting way to play it to make it come alive on one guitar. So I want to focus on that tonight, on arranging songs. And the Grateful Dead, of course, as you know, that first song came from, were a big part of the music that I learned to play guitar on, played as a teenager. As I've come around to this project of arranging a lot of songs, I've wound up making two videos for Homespun in Woodstock, New York, teaching how to play these arrangements of acoustic arrangements of Grateful Dead songs. So what I just played there was a new arrangement that I just did for the second volume of the Homespun video series. And it's really not, what I play there is really not like what you would hear one guitar doing on the original recording of that. My approach to arranging, especially band music like that, is to try to make a band sound happen on one guitar. So in order to do that, taking ideas not just from the rhythm guitar, also from the lead guitar, also from the bass, also from the drums, and trying to get the feel of the whole ensemble. So the way I look at it, of learning the chords to a song is really just the first step. Then comes the fun part, which is really trying to get the feel right. In that case, I played around with the key. I wound up dropping the key. The original is in C, and I played that in A just now. So that's always a good thing to keep in mind when you're arranging songs, is to try it in different keys and see if it might fall on your voice better in a different key. So, and the other thing about that arrangement is I'm playing in drop D tuning. You know, I'm in playing the songs in the key of A as I'm playing it here. I'm in drop D tuning. And the whole reason that I wound up doing that is because of that signature riff of Casey Jones, which normally would be played kind of up the neck, like. But I kind of thought, wouldn't it be cool to hear that down an octave down low on the neck? And so I started playing around with that, and then to go. But to get that low note, I had to tune down because I didn't have that available there. So that's something that I'll do, is kind of fool around, like there's a note that I want, if I can't quite reach it, you know, maybe I can drop my sixth string, and then I can. So that was how I arrived in drop D tuning for that. And everything else really just fell into place as soon as I did that. The little lead section, which is based on around the melody of the tune. And the whole arrangement is just really bass heavy, you know, it's a blues. And typically when I'm playing, I'm focusing in on kind of one zone of the guitar, not necessarily playing everything. But in this case, all that stuff is just on two strings, maybe. And a lot of good percussive snaps going just from the pick on the strings. There's the drum part. So that's really was probably my biggest focus on this, is to try to make that rhythm happen. And that's what I got to say is really the number one, the way I look at it, the number one most important thing about arranging is to get that, the rhythmic feel, to get the groove down. The rest of it, the frills, none of that really matters if you don't, you know, have that rhythmic feel. So I want to just play a couple of examples of some other songs from this Dead project, and along similar lines about trying to kind of create a rhythmic feel. And in the interest of time, I'll just do little bits of little samples of these songs. So to take another well-known song from the Dead, Truckin', so which is basically a blues in E. And if you listen to the original recording of that, there's a rhythm guitar kind of going like a, playing E chords like that. Truckin', got my chips cashed in. Keep truckin', like the two-dollar man. Together, more or less in line. Just keep truckin' on. So I can play the song like that, get it across, those are the right chords and everything. But for me, there's something missing. And that thing that's missing is that we have a walking bass going on, we got drums, we got electric lead guitar, we got all these other things that make that more interesting. Like that's just, I want to try to get more stuff happening on the guitar than that. So the way I wound up arranging Truckin' for the Homespun project is like this. Like the doo-dah man, together, more or less in line, we'll just keep trucking on. So I'll just do that little bit of it, because that song is about 20 verses anyway. So, that to me, that's an arrangement that I could start to really, you know, get behind and keep going for 20 verses of that song. So it's really, I'm almost really playing bass to a large degree in that, and grabbing a little something from the lead guitar as well. Let me give you one other really simple example. Another well-known Dead song, Uncle John's Band, right? So if you listen to the original recording of that, you've got a guitar kind of strumming in key of G like this. Just play the intro. So, really straightforward, just kind of folk strumming, right? Again, in the band context, that works because you got bass, you got drums, you got other things going on and keeping it interesting. So for me to play that song solo, I started to think about how could I get a little bit more of that, of the feel of that original. And I wound up dropping the pick on that and playing this instead, finger style, with a little slap of my thumb like this. Again, to me, like, that has so much more groove to it, that little bit of slap. Plus, playing fingerstyle on that song, I could play that little melody. Which is just adapted from the lead guitar on the original recording. So sometimes these little changes, like that, just even a different right-hand approach for a song kind of unlocks it for me. to play another song off the Dead Project here. A very different kind of mode.
I have everything up to their very first album. Not everything, but up to From the Mars Hotel.
You'll hear the guitar pretty well out there?
Yeah.
Like? So I'll play this one and then tell you a little bit about the process of arranging it. It is important, especially on this song. All the years combined, they melt into a dream. A broken angel sings from a guitar. In the end, there's just a song. Come crying up the night through all the broken dreams and vanished years. Stella Blue. Stella Blue. All the cars are down. There's nothing left to see. It's just the pavement left. Broken dreams. And there's still that song. Come crying like the wind down every lonely street that's ever been. Still a blue. nothing you can hold for very long. And when you hear that song, come crying like the wind, seems like all this life is just a dream. Stella Blue.